conditions are given, x equal to 0, when x equal to 0 velocity is 2 meter per second, you need to find velocity when x equal to 5 meters. Okay, no one? Okay, someone got the answer. Okay, whenever you see acceleration changing equal to, let's say, x square, and if I have to form a differential equation, what will come in our mind? Dv by dt, right? That is the first thing that will come in our mind or not? So let's try to write that dv by dt is equal to x square. Now what is the problem with this differential equation? There are three variables. And you just have two sides. On one side there can be one variable to integrate, on the other side there will be another variable to integrate. But if you have three variables, you cannot put one variable on one side and another variable on the other side. Okay? So what you should do? So can I write acceleration in terms of v and x? Can I write acceleration in terms of v and x? Is there an option? Yeah. What is that? We have done this when we have done graphical analysis. Yes or no? You multiply and divide by x. So when you do that, this is how I can write acceleration or not. What is dx by dt? V. So you can see that this differential equation got transformed into two variables now. Okay? Now you can integrate this. So V dV is equal to x squared dx. Now when x equal to 0, what is the velocity? 2. So like this you write 0, 2, and then when x equal to 5, I need to find the velocity. So let me write just V. Okay, then over here I get v square by 2. The limits are from 2 to v, and this is what? X cube by 3. 0 to 5. Okay? So here what will I get? V square by 2 minus 2 square by 2 equals to 5 cube by 3. This is what I get or not? Right? So I can solve this for velocity now. I'll get the value of velocity. All of you understood this problem? No. What is the issue? After this. This. How this came. See, have you understood this? So I have cross multiplied dx, that's it. Limits, it is given, right? When x equal to 0, velocity is 2. So when x equal to 0, velocity is 2. When x equal to 5, what is the velocity? Okay? So you have to solve few questions your own. You cannot understand everything just by sitting here. Getting it? This is the basic introduction of calculus, or let's say more specific, integration. Okay? So we'll be using now integration by solving numericals going forward. So most of the learning will happen when you are solving questions. Any doubts? Anything on this? Nothing? Okay. Let's take up few examples. Let's say that initial velocity is u1. Here initial velocity is u2. Its acceleration is a1 and that point acceleration is a2. Distance between them is d. What is the What is the velocity of approach? Initial velocity of approach is what? U1 plus U2. Initial velocity of approach is U1 plus U2. What is the acceleration of approach? A1 plus A2. Both accelerations are trying to create less separation between them. They are trying to approach. Isn't it? Both are contributing to approach both the objects. Yes or no? So acceleration of approach is A1 plus A2. A1 plus A2. Now if I have to find out time it takes for both the objects to meet, then I use S equal to UT plus half AT square, where S is distance of approach, which is D. So D is equal to U1 plus U2 times T plus half A1 plus A2 into T square. Same question if you try to solve it at the earlier way, the way you have solved the earlier question, it will take a lot of time. Okay? But you can just solve in one line if you have concept of relative motion clear. Okay? Clear? No doubts? Let's take up one more numerical. No words, stop. Clear, right? This is clear? Let's take one more example. This is U1, U2, A1, A2. Distance between them is D. Find out, I mean you have to write the equation like this. I am trying to find out the time it will take to meet. Anyone written the equation? Okay, should I write? Chalo, let me write down now. Guys, focus here. What is the velocity of approach? How much it is? Initial velocity of approach is U1 minus U2. Getting it? This velocity of approach. Acceleration of approach is what? A2 minus A1. Distance of approach is D. So D is equal to U1 minus U2 times T. Okay? Plus half A2 minus A1 times T square. See how simply you can get the answer. Okay? Any doubts? Please write down one very important aspect about relative velocity. When observer is looking at the object, observer will find its own velocity. Observer will find its own velocity to be how much? Zero. Observer location will not change with respect to itself. It is zero. Observer will be at rest. That's a very strong statement, because the numerical which I am giving you now, you cannot hope to solve without using that concept. Okay. Try solving this numerical now. This is an equilateral triangle. You have these three points A, B, C. Side length is A. Okay? Now, all these three points A, B, and C, they have started moving. The way they are moving is like this. B's velocity is towards C, C's velocity is towards A, and A's velocity is towards B. Well, all of them moving with constant speed u, and every time they are facing the object next to it. So suppose C goes this way, so B's velocity will be rotated like this. B goes that way, A velocity will be rotated like that. Getting it? So the kind of motion you'll observe is this. Like this, they will converge. And what will happen, that equal triangle will rotate. So it will be like this at some point in time, then it will be like that, and slowly the equilateral triangle will converge. Okay, you need to find out time when they all meet. How much time will it take for them to meet? Now you cannot solve this question right now with whatever knowledge you have. If you are trying to solve it with absolute velocity, it will be very difficult. Mathematically it will be very extensive. But if you are clear about relative velocity concept, the answer is just two step away. No integration, nothing. Should I give you a hint? One hint? The hint is, just take two points. The time it takes for two points to meet is same as time it takes for all the points to meet. Yes or no? That is hint number one. Just consider two points. Okay, next hint is, if you're taking B and C, let's assume you're taking B point and C point. Assume B is the observer. Who is observing? You take C as observer, then B will be approaching, otherwise C will go away. If your C is the observer, you're observing B. Okay? The velocity of C will be 0. C will be 0. And how B will move? Toward. So distance of approach is how much? A. If you know velocity of approach, time you will find out. C is the observer. So C will be addressed. Take two points, B and C. All the focus here now. Its absolute velocity is like this, u, and its velocity is like that. Yes or no? U, 60 degrees. This is the situation right now. Can you tell me what is the velocity of approach between B and C? Velocity of approach is how much? Simply, I'm asking. Alright. You take component of this. The component over here is u cos 60. So velocity approach is u plus u cos 60. This is 2u by 3. With this velocity, you will observe B is coming towards C. Okay, this into T should be equal to A. So T is 3u by 2, no? Please write down something. You will not learn anything if you just fold your hands and sit. Wasting your time, like my time also. 2a by 3u. So this is the answer. Getting it? Now you understand the power of relative velocity concept. You cannot solve this problem with absolute velocity. If you do, it will take a lot of time. Understood? Okay. Can you find out the distance? Can you find out the distance B has to move? This distance is how much? What? No integration, nothing. How much is this distance?
By
2a by 3u. This is the time it will take to go there, and speed is u. So distance is 2a by 3. So this distance is 2a by 3. Speed into time, distance, constant speed. You don't need to know the path to find out the distance. If you know the speed and if you know the time, speed into time is distance. Okay? Okay, let's take up a few more numericals. Please solve this, all of you. There are two cars, A and B. The distance between them is 10 meters. Okay? This car is going forward with 2.5 meter per second and this is coming towards the first car with 2.5 meter per second like this. Okay? Fine? Now there is a crow on top of the first car. Okay? Now what this bird does is that it flies with the velocity of 10 meter per second. Like, what height over 10 meter per second? It flies with 1 meter per second. Okay? It flies with this much velocity. What it does is that it goes from this car to that car, then from it doesn't take a rest. Okay? Something crazy is this bird is doing. From here it goes to this car and then again go back to that car. So like this, keeps on doing. Till the car they are at a different lane, doesn't collide. Till the car are crossing each other. Okay? You need to find out the distance travelled by the crow. How much distance the crow has travelled? Keep quiet. It's a simple question. That's the thing.
Sir, when the crow is going slower than the car.
Yeah, crow is going slower than the car. Good point. 4 meter per second. By the time crow is forward, the car will come and hit from behind. In fact, crow will be backwards, car will be forwards. Keep quiet and solve, please. Keep quiet. Okay, somebody is saying 8 meters. Others? 5 into t, so t will be equal to 2 seconds. So 2 seconds is there for the crow to go back and forth. Okay, so in 2 seconds the distance will be, okay, the crow will be just in the mid air somewhere. He will not, is it? It doesn't even reach the, oh that's so sad. Anyways, whatever its velocity is, velocity into time it takes to collide. Okay? So 4 into 2 is the answer. Speed into time, distance. It doesn't matter whether it is going back and forth. I could have made it little complicated by saying that every time it reaches a car, it spends 2 seconds there, then comes.